make that look smooth in post.
Hey guys, I'm Nate, welcome back to the workshop. In the past, when using our backyard forge, we've been using these stainless steel tongs to pull things out. And they are stainless steel, which means that they don't melt in the furnace, but they do get red hot and very soft, to the point that trying to pick up the crucible just makes them bend. And I'm pretty sure these things were originally designed to be used on salad. So you can see we haven't been using these for quite what they were designed for, so today we're gonna see if we can build ourselves some more industrial tongs that can really take the heat of our forge. We've got some mild steel bars that we picked up at Home Depot, along with some steel hardware, and we're gonna try and form two pairs of tongs. One pair that's designed to reach down inside the top of the forge and lift our crucible out, and a second pair that's designed to grab our crucible from the side so we can easily pour it out. To be building these tongs, we'll use a drill, a hacksaw, we'll probably end up using the bench vise, and a pair of channel locks as well. First, let's just sort of get a measurement idea for how long we want these tongs to be. I'm not trying to make tongs that I can operate up here, just something about that long. For the most part, these will work just like a pair of scissors. We'll have a hinge point in the middle, and then somewhere around here, we'll try and get them to twist 90 degrees so that we have the flat face pointing at the crucible. We'll then take another piece of steel and bolt that onto the end in sort of a claw shape so we can really grab onto the crucible. If we just take some more of the steel bar beyond where my hand is and double that over, that'll give a nice handle that's easy to hold on to. I will still be using the furnace gloves while I'm using these tongs, so I do want something that's easy to operate and doesn't require a ton of manual dexterity because they're pretty thick. This is all very much an eyeballed sort of experiment. If you want longer tongs, you just use maybe the whole bar. If you want shorter tongs, then you're gonna burn your hands, but just use less. I'm gonna go for right about there. Let's see how long it takes me to cut through this 1/8 inch thickness, 3/4 inch wide mild steel bar using a standard hacksaw. That wasn't too bad. I actually got through that in like 30 seconds. Pretty good. Let's try the next one. We've now got the two shorter bars that will be the main body of the first set of tongs, and we have the two pieces that we cut off of those. And we're going to be using these for something as well. We can cut two shorter pieces out of one side of this bar, and those will become the two curved claws that will actually hold onto our crucible. It looks like to get a good curved claw shape, we aren't gonna have to cut this whole bar right in half. That would be a little bit too big. But just something, I don't know, 5 or 6 inches long should be a pretty good claw, I think. We actually want to make sure that our claws don't wrap all the way around our crucible, because then the two halves would just hit each other and they wouldn't actually grab the crucible at all. So we want them shorter than that, so it just grabs onto the sides. Again, I'm just kind of eyeballing it here. Now let's cut these two pieces off of our short bar. Got a magnet attached to our bench vise here, and it's really picking up quite a bit of steel filings from this. I think we want to put our scissor hinge pretty much in the middle here. There are advantages to having it higher or lower. If it's lower down, nearer to the crucible, then it's easier to hold pressure on it that lets us lift the crucible up out of the forge. But if it's higher up, then we have more space to fit around a crucible and maybe even a larger crucible than this one. So I think just putting it right in the middle will be a good middle ground. It should be fairly easy enough to hold pressure to lift our crucible up and out, but we should also have enough space that we can fit around the mouth of even our taller and bigger crucibles. The hardware we have is 1/4 inch bolts, so I have a 1/4 inch drill bit, but I don't have a punch to get my hole started, so I'm gonna be switching out using a smaller drill bit just to put a little bit of a divot into the steel, and then I'll switch back to my 1/4 inch bit. That should work. I don't have any sort of special drill bit. This is a normal drill bit that I'm gonna be using to get through this mild steel, and if you use it correctly, it should work pretty well. There's a couple of things that you want to remember when you're drilling into metal though. One is you don't want to use a high speed. That will create a lot of friction, which will heat up the tip of the drill bit, and that can make it get soft. If you keep a low speed, you should be able to get through the metal no problem. The other thing to remember is that it's always good to use some kind of oil when you're cutting through metal. I don't have any machine oil around, but I do have this cooking oil, which, while not perfect, should still do the job. Doesn't need a lot. Steel hardware fits beautifully through that little hole with just a tiny, tiniest bit of extra space, almost none, but it fits through nice and easily. Just what we want. Just got a little bit of a burr on the bottom of our steel, so let's take some sandpaper and just get rid of that. Now as a quick test, if we fit our bolt through both of those, we've got ourselves a hinged pair of tongs, or scissors, or really they're neither of those yet, it's just two pieces of metal on a hinge, but making good progress. Let's see if we can't bend the ends of our steel 90 degrees so that the flat portion will be facing the crucible. I like that. That's pretty good alignment, it looks like right there. So now we need to add little claws onto both ends. First, of course, we need to add a little bit of curve into this bar. It's straight right now, which is not going to be good for grabbing a crucible. I'm just putting it in the vise, bending it in one spot. I'm going to have to move on to using tools after this because my hands are not going to be strong enough. I think that will work great. Now we need to attach one of the curve pieces to each of these handles. And of course, that means more drilling holes. As a final step before we assemble everything using our hardware, let's take our extra bits of steel and fold those over to create our handles. All right, that's looking like it should work. Let's start assembling with hardware. Looks pretty good, not too shaky. Now these pieces are going to be assembled largely the same way, but they don't need to have any play to them. These aren't supposed to move, so we're just going to tighten them down a lot. Seems to be working, but I think we could make it a little bit easier to use if the claw pieces were a little bit more in line with the shape of the crucible. In this case, that actually means bending the bars a little bit more inward. That way they should be lined up with the direction the crucible sits. There we go, that is perfect. Look at that, it just goes nicely down. Our little claws are perpendicular to the walls of the crucible. Easy to grab. These things are working pretty well so far. Of course, it's going to be a little bit more of a long-term test than that when we start using them in the furnace. We'll see if the hardware holds up nicely or if the change from getting hot to cooling down over and over ends up weakening them somehow. It's possible that we'll have to come back later and weld some of these pieces in place. We have tongs that are really good for picking up our crucible from the top, but if we want to go and pour it, these aren't going to do too much for us. So what we need to do now is build a second set of tongs that has these claws facing the other direction so that we can come in at it from the side. All of our pieces are cut, our holes are drilled. Let's just bend some handles into this and then do our final assembly. Wait, that's not right. There we go. Now these ones will attach mostly the same way, but instead of attaching them with the claws perpendicular to the posts, we're going to go parallel. Let's give that a test. So with our sideways tong, we should be able to just come in, grab it, tip. We can even hold it upside down and pour out all of the dust that's down in there. That works pretty great. Ha! Yeah! And now I can be farther away from the metal as it's pouring, and our tongs aren't going to get destroyed like our salad tongs kept doing. Guys, thanks for watching. If you aren't a subscriber yet, just hit the bomb to get in the club. If you missed our last video or need to check it out again, here it is up at the top, and down there you can see what the internet thinks that you should be watching next. That's it for now. Have fun, be safe, see you tomorrow.